All right, hello guys, and welcome back to another episode of Eternal Darkness. We are still playing as Edwin Lindsay, and we are currently making our way through Mantarok's tomb in Cambodia. Field that we had to deal with. It's pretty low if you're wondering why there's bugs crawling all over the screen. Yeah, there's a force field that we brought down last episode that we never really dealt with. Oh shit, I don't want to be poisoned for too long. So we're going back up a floor to deal with that. Now that we have our summon monster spell. Yeah, man, this character's not doing too hot. Hold on, let's, recover some sanity for the poor guy. And yeah, if you're joining us for the first time, please check the entire playlist. This is a pretty story-driven game. I don't was merely watching the just random levels. It's pretty fun, but probably not the most thing to look at. This temple is we're almost back up to the floor above this one, right? Maybe just one more hallway? Oh, god damn it. They make some of these traps really hard to avoid, and then other ones like that are impossible to avoid. Yeah, okay, cool. This is the way back up. That is good. So hopefully we're almost done exploring this tomb. I feel like we got pretty far down. It wasn't that long when we went through this Elia in Chapter 2. I know that previously, so it really shouldn't be too bad. Okay, what I need to try to do is make sure I avoid setting off the poison gas here, because that's what'll screw me if I'm not too careful. Okay, I forget which hallway it is that has the the wall that we here in front of. I'm hoping it's this one. Okay, that's pretty impossible to avoid right there. Yeah, there it is. Sweet. There appears to be a hole in the wall. It is large enough for a small dog to pass through. Well, I suppose a trapper counts as a small dog. So let's cast this spell. And summon this little creep. Oh, sorry, I should do that. After a trapper has been summoned, press A to trap an enemy when it's targeted using the right trigger. Press start to release control of the trapper. I think, yeah, I control the trapper with the left analog stick. So let's just have him crawl through here. Oh, no, no. Let's have him crawl through here. And there are some creepy monsters around, but I think he's alright. Attack him. He'll probably attack me, though, in a little bit. So let's hit this button. What does this do? Does this move this wall out of my way? Oh, okay, cool. It just opens up the, examine. The trapper spots a panel and set in the floor. Okay, let's just detonate. And sadly, he dies. Actually, not sadly, I don't give a shit about a trapper. Cool. Grab this. Secreted inside the alcove, a rune awaits, its energy silently corroding the air about it. Okay, now we have all four color spells, and of course they break through the wall. There was two there, right? Not just the one? Maybe the other one will be nice and wait in the room while I deal with the first one. Where is your third head? That's to say. Okay, let's equip our sword for the finishing blow, because I don't want to waste more ammo. Bam. And I guess I'll load this up and keep it equipped, because there was a spider web in this room, which I want to see what was hiding behind it. Which of course means I'm going to be fighting this guy. Okay, he's over there. I don't think I can finish him off with my sword from this range, but I should be able to finish him off with my handgun, right? Yeah, there we go. Sweet. Use the brush. Excellent. Pick it up. That's just the codex for the Mantarok thing, right? Yeah, okay. Cool. Switch back over. Actually, switch back over to my torch so I can see in some of those hallways. Alright, that was awesome. So now we have new types of... I forget how the Mantarok thing works in this game. Because I don't think, like, purple... I don't think it fits into that whole pattern. I think it just changes what the spells do. Like, it has, like, a weird, twisted chaos effect to a spell when you use the purple thing, I think. Or maybe purple was... Maybe it's just better than all of them, or, like, neutral or something. Because I know, like, if you enchant a weapon with blue and then run into a red enemy, you'll do extra damage to them. But if you enchant it with blue and then run into a green enemy, resist your attack. Which I'm aware is something I did, I think, in Chapter 3. I, like, put blue magic on my sword and then was fighting, I think it was the bishop. And I was like, man, this guy can take a lot of hits. But it was also a duh moment of, like, oh, right, I'm not using the right spell against him. I buffed my weapon to do more damage, but against a guy who resists that buff. Oh. Okay, bye all. I can't tell if this is a new room or if we've been through this one already. I think we have. There'd be enemies in it if it was new. Alright, come on, Edwin. Let's hurry up and hopefully finish your level relatively soon. Oh shit, hit poison gas. That's not fun. Let's keep running. Okay, yeah, and this is the room where we got the summon monster spell. So pretty much this is back where this video started. Okay, I can't believe no traps have been set off yet. There we go, there they are. Let's try to avoid the last bit of these. Alright. Oh, crap. Okay. The blue ones aren't too bad, are they? Wow, this one's really tiny. Holy crap. Little guy. You know what? That's a lot of enemies. Fuck this. Oh, what are y'all doing? Get out of here. Get out of here. Okay, you have to shoot them in the head when they're doing that. Oh, no, I didn't mean to press B. Oh, that was a waste. Whoa. Okay. Blue ones explode. Good to know. Did they all, like, take themselves out by doing that, though? That would have been nice. Oh, they did. Nice. Okay, sweet. So, yeah, screw the blue enemies. They're pretty easy. They just blow themselves up once you do enough damage to them. And there's there's a spell scroll here. Oh, this is going to be summon monster. Oops, already went and did that. Okay. So let's just go up here. We're probably at the end of Edwin's journey. Ugh. Mantarok, you left your slime everywhere, buddy. Is there no cutscene here? Okay, there is. I was gonna say, this guy's gotta freak out at the sight of this monster. Oh, geez, two of these things? Oh. Hey, get rocked. See, I guess Mantarok is more powerful than all. Okay, I guess this is the end of his, Edwin's little journey here. Unless we have to make our way all the way back up through the temple, which would suck. I doubt they'd do that to us, though. Oh, hey, it's Elia. Or what's left of her.
Do not touch the heart, flesh and bone, lest you become like me, a dead body. Many centuries ago. It was not easy hiding from the dark ones as they searched me. At first they passed by, not thinking that the heart was inside my dead body. But I was forced to find refuge here. You must seal the heart so it never contacts your flesh, and take it to the gathering of light. Take the heart there, or the world shall fall under a reign of eternal darkness. Of reality can only be pulled back so far, mortal. Take your stand and fight the darkness.
Damn, man. I forgot the role Elia played in the story, holding on to the heart of Mantarok for a long time. Fair enough. So that's where our grandfather hid the heart of Mantarok, and I guess we're gonna take that for ourselves now. I feel like that's the important thing we discovered in this chapter. You know what? Let's heal up some of her sanity, since we have the ability to do that. I don't think I've done it once yet. There we go, that should be fine. Now my question is, are there monsters in the mansion yet? Was it down here? No, next one over. Whoa. Yeah? No, not this one? What the hell? Where'd they hide that, Here we go. Alex discovers a pulp novel written by one Dr. Edwin Lindsay. Amongst the books on the shelf, this is where the Tome of Eternal Darkness indicated that something of value was hidden beyond this book. Boom. With the book removed, a secret cache is revealed. Inside is the heart of Mantarok, encased in glass to protect the world from its corrosive energies. Yes, let's take the heart of Mantarok. Okay. So that bit's done. Now I believe if we come up here, I still don't know what to do about this, like, very obvious hidden door. Oh, there's runes in front of it now. Those weren't there before. Okay, let's, spell list, dispel magic, cast, or is it they're red, so we should do blue, right? Wait, why? Oh, she still won't. God damn it. Okay, well, might not be able to do much with that, but I think we can do this one. That's really annoying that she won't go through that obvious door. But hey, we got rid of that stained glass window. As the magical window fades away, a piece of parchment that the maiden was holding is left behind, floating in midair. It appears to be a chapter page. Should Alex take the chapter page? Absolutely. Okay. Oh, damn, that's one hell of a spell. Taking a lot of runes. Is he summoning something? Oh, yep. What?
I am not your food today. I am your master. Your task is to guard the artifact before you. Let no one touch it.
Oh, that's the one that, So the blue one that Kareem's guarding is the one that the green guys are weak against, but that's the red one behind there, which is strong against them. Or sorry, the green guys are strong against the blue one, they're weak against the red one, which is what that thing's guarding. So, this is kind of a shorter episode. You know what, I'll load the initial cutscene for the next one. Let's just save over that file. And let's just play the intro chapter thing to Heresy, and then we will play this one next time on Eternal Darkness. Paranoia. Oh, Centering the Inquisition, nice.
With the fear of devilry running rampant, the ancients' corruption extended far beyond mortal knowledge, corrupting all that could be corrupted. My researches uncovered an interesting incident. A Franciscan monk named Paul Luther was traveling through the region of Amiens during the witch hunts of the Inquisition. Now, under martial law, the Inquisition prevented anyone from leaving the town and its nearby cathedral. For everyone was suspect.
Welcome to Oublier Cathedral, Brother Luther. Glad that our sacred order can bestow hospitality on our Franciscan brethren.
I shall not impose, Excellency. I merely request lodging and the viewing of the sacred relic, the Hand of Jude.
The Hand
Many
of Jude?
Have traveled far and even risked their lives for a glimpse of the hallowed relic's true splendor. Of course, it would be wise to keep quiet till you stay. The Inquisition is here for a reason.
Most creepy ass fucker. See it from this town.
I am sure that will not be a problem. Amiens appears to be a peaceful hamlet.
It appears to be. But deviancy is secreted in the most deceptive places, which I believe is the case with Amiens.
Then I wish you luck in your search.
The Inquisition does not need luck, Brother Luther. Faith and purity are our guides.
That dude is the most corrupted looking guy I have seen since we played as Anthony. What are we at now? We're at about 20 minutes. The door is locked. Maybe I'll play up until we get the Tome of Eternal Darkness for this guy. Because it's usually after that that shit hits the fan. So let's come up here. I feel like we don't really have a mission as this guy right now. We're kind of just hanging out. Is there anything up on the main? The altar is bereft of holy... No crucifix, no Bible, no sacrament of any kind. Paul is disturbed by the sight. What faith does this order practice? Is he already out of stamina? Oh my god, Paul. Come on. This character's got a cool name, though. Paul Luther. Okay, what's back here? Oh, treasure chest. Heavy wooden chest sits against the room's wall. It appears to be old and worn. Should Paul open the chest? Absolutely. Oh, a crossbow. Nice. Nothing else to do here? Seems weird. Maybe this... the rat carries robes and cloaks for ceremonial use. As Paul draws the robes back, something tumbles from inside. Paul has found the podium key. Nice. Okay, so we got a weapon and a key. Is there ammo for our crossbow, by the way? Back here somewhere? That would be very... meditation rod. Interesting. Oh, there's one bolt in the crossbow. That actually does not... That's a little scary. Also, I really don't like how little stamina Paul has. So where's the podium? Is it... Maybe over here somewhere? Ah, that looks like it. This tabernacle is fashioned from aged varnish mahogany. Its doors are closed, and there doesn't appear to be any way of opening them manually. What? Oh, okay. So that's... Huh. Are we going to have to use a spell on that? Hey, crossbow bolt. Okay, like, Paul's got to be tripping out now. There's crossbow bolts up, leaning on a pew next to the altar. Can we come over here? Yeah, we can. Oh, that's just the organ, though. Playing the organ is a daunting challenge for someone like Paul, who has no musical talent. Paul would be if there was some music to play. What? He has no musical talent. I guess we'll have to play the organ at some point once we find, like, music sheets or something. What do we got down here? Oh, what's this? The desk bears a leather-bound book. Pick it up. Found the Book of Reliquaries. Can we read that? Can we check that? This is the forgeries of the reliquaries, dating back to the late 13th century. Exquisitely illuminated and bound in hard leather, it reads. Doubtless many obscure orders requiring more income than can be garnered from the tith. Resorted to forging ancient relics to bring people from outside their region to their diocese, I guess is how you pronounce that, and thus become more lucrative. While it could be said that a false hope is still hope, relics such as Cuthbert's jawbone, the hand of Jude, and the infamous thigh bone flute of Canoft, deceive the righteous unjustly. Their existence is, as true relics is the utmost heresy. Okay. But, there is a relic here that isn't just, a forgery meant to draw more people into this particular church. What do we got back here? Oh, steel mace. Done. Let's equip that. Yeah, I can't believe we don't have the tome yet. Oh, okay, we're probably going to get it here. The monk forces you back, explaining that one of the order's most sacred rites is taking place and that the presence of a Franciscan would be troublesome. Okay. Take these crossbows from you, good sir. I really don't know where to use this key or what podium we're looking for. I guess we'll head back upstairs, though. Do we go? Oh, is it on like the back of the altar? The altar's bereft of any adornment. Is there like a slot back here to use the key? No. Interesting. And we couldn't use it. Okay, let me look at the key. Maybe checking it will give us a clue. Thin bass key for the podium in the cathedral. Alright, well, I'm not sure where we're supposed to use that key. But, this episode's gone on for long. Pick it up from here. Brother Luther's, quest. I'll just hit save here. Screw it. Alright, well, I hope you guys enjoyed this one. We got to finish up Edwin's story, and now it looks like we're back in... Honestly, I think this is the same church we were in as Anthony, which is pretty cool. And clearly there's still weird cult stuff going on, and we're probably going to have to fight that monster that Pius summoned to defend the relic here. So looking forward to playing through this chapter, and I hope to see you guys next time. Have a good one. Take care.